Hello friends, let us learn about a new topic today, that is on pyonephrosis. So what is pyonephrosis? Pyonephrosis is collection of pus in the, if this is the kidney, whenever there is collection of pus in the pelvic calcium system, then that is called as pyonephrosis. So pyonephrosis is collection of pus in pelvic calcium system. Okay, so what are the causes of pyonephrosis? Number one, infection of pre-existing hydronephrosis. Whenever there is pre-existing hydronephrosis and whenever there is infection in that, that may lead to pyonephrosis. Number two, it may occur following acute pyelonephrosis. After acute pyelonephrosis, then pyonephrosis may occur. Pyelonephritis, infection of the kidney, this might occur. Then the third one, it can occur as a complication of renal calculus. Okay, so these are the causes of pyonephrosis. What are the clinical features? This can usually occur unilateral, usually. So it has a triad, that is number one, anemia. Then there may be fever and there may be loin swelling. This loin swelling is smooth, soft, non-mobile and also not moving with respiration. The patient may have fever, which is with chills and rigors. Okay. And this pyonephrosis may be seen associated with, it may be associated with other illnesses like cystitis, pyuria and burning micturition. Okay, so what are the investigations that you do? Investigations are plain x-ray abdomen, plain x-ray kidney, ureter, bladder. This shows renal calculus. And then intravenous urethrography shows hydronephrosis can be seen. And if it is cystoscopy, this is reveals cystitis with efflux of purulent pus. Through ureteric orifice. I'll just draw this diagram because this is what is diagnostic of this disease, that is pyonephrosis. So if this is the bladder and if this is the ureter, now when you pass a cystoscope through it, think that this is the cystoscope, you will see the pus which is coming out of this ureteric orifice. This can be seen, and you will also see the inflammation of the gallbladder, which is cystitis. So you see cystitis with pus. So this is what is seen in cystoscopy. So then these are necessary for investigations. And then if you do treatment, the treatment includes, first, this is a surgical emergency. Why? Because there is a threatening for permanent renal damage. So because this is an emergency, permanent renal damage. So first we give parenteral antibiotics are given immediately. And then kidney is drained. but pus may be too thick. For thick pus, what you do is you will first give a loin incision. If this is the thing, here there will be the kidney. So you will have to give a loin incision, and then you will have to insert a tube which is a nephrostomy tube to the outside from the into the kidney, thus causing drainage of kidney. So give loin incision and then put a nephrostomy tube. Can be Cabot's nephrostomy tube or Mallinckrodt's catheter. Anything can be kept. Mallinckrodt's catheter, it is placed and pus is drained. If kidney is totally destroyed, then you can do subcapsular nephrectomy. Why subcapsular? Because this prevents other kidney to get the infection. This prevents spread of infection to other kidney. Then, if there is bilateral pyelonephrosis, what do you do? If there is bilateral pyelonephrosis, then you should do bilateral nephrostomy. And then J stent is kept to keep the ureters patent. Okay. So this is about the pyonephrosis. Thank you guys for watching my lecture. In my next class, I will explain about renal carbuncle. Thank you for watching my lecture. If you have any doubts, please comment it in the comment section. If you feel something is inadequate in this lecture, please comment it in the comment section. Thank you for watching my lecture. Thank you.